On today's episode, we are going to talk about launching a new book on social media and starting your day off right.
Hola amigos, and welcome to another episode of Tip for Tip, where I ask your marketing question in exchange for a tip in your industry. My name is Aaron.
And my name is Christian. And today we have Rich Cavaness.
Aaron and Christian, I'm going to be launching a new book this month. I want to know, what would you do? What would you recommend to me, advertising and marketing-wise, to get that out to the masses?
All right, Rich. So we've done this before once for another client, and I think something that works really well. But it goes something like this, where you give away your book for free, and then you charge people for shipping. And then in that landing page, you have what is called a
one-time
bump. We have a bump.
Bump. Yes.
So a bump is it's around a 30 some dollar value item that you want to give away. Usually it's some kind of worksheet that goes with the book. Sometimes a lot of these like coaching books are great reading material, but then you need maybe that actionable list of things or worksheet that you kind of like fill out with the book. So that's something that you can sell separately. And then finally, after that bump in that landing page, then you can do something more like a workshop. And then charge, that's maybe like a 90 some dollar value workshop where you can actually go sit one-on-one person with that person buying the book for free. And that way you can kind of create that funnel to make some money. And at the same time, you're giving away your book for free.
Right. And I guess the key there is that whenever you do the free shipping is that you charge enough that you aren't going to lose money on the book. So we say to charge between $7 to $8 for the free shipping anywhere in the U.S. And your book probably costs about
free book.
About $5 or so. And then the actual, the shipping costs $2 or $3. But that way you don't lose money when you're doing that. And everybody loves a free offer. So that's a great way. And then also, we had a friend of mine who just launched a book, and she did something called Thunderclap, which is social sharing. And this website will send out your book via Amazon to hundreds of thousands of people. You just have to get so many people to commit. Say, for example, 100 people. And then those people say, Christian decided to support them. He would say, okay, I'm going to share it on my Twitter page. And I'm gonna support you. And he has 3,500 followers. That moves it up in the tick. And so whenever you reach like 100 people, you potentially could reach 150,000 plus people because of all the social reach. And you have to reach that number. And then once you do, they'll send out an email or a message, and it will go out to all of those people. So you can really have a huge impact on Amazon right away.
And it's called Thunderclap.
Thunderclap. I don't know the website, actually. We may be able to put it below, but it's Thunderclap.
All together. Okay, cool. All right, Rich, hopefully that was a good insight for you. Let's hear your tip for us.
So my tip for you today is this. How you start your day is going to determine how the rest of your day goes. I really want to encourage and challenge all the listeners to make sure they do some type of exercise in the mornings, that you're going through your goals, you're going through your plan for the day, that you're going through some kind of a spiritual study, but make sure that you're spending that first hour that you get out of bed. I want you to spend that doing really productive things, making sure that you're getting ready for what's coming for your day, and then being grateful, having gratitude as well for the things that are happening in your life is really important.
That was a great tip. Actually, I have something to kind of share, because I started doing something like that, very similar. It's called it's a journal that you do, and you can buy this journal online. I think Tim Ferriss was the one who originally advertised this, and that's how we found out about it. But I just bought it like a sketchbook, and I put the questions in here. But it basically goes like this. In the morning, you write three things that you're grateful for, and then you write three things that would make today great, and then you write your daily affirmations. And then at nighttime, you write three awesome things that happened today, and then how could you have made the day better? And I gotta say, it's crazy how little things like that will shift your mindset, especially like first thing in the morning, you write those things, and it makes a world of difference. for the rest of your day. And then at the end of the night, you kind of write, you know, the things, what went wrong or what you could have done better. And you kind of really, you know, close it off really well. I don't know exactly what the name of the title or the book is. It's something journal, and they sell it on Amazon, but you can create your own for free.
This whole time I've been thinking, I know the answer to that, and as soon as we stop recording, I will think of it. But yes, it's very, very powerful. So great tip. All right, so today's question of the day, very fitting for this episode, do you have a morning routine? Well, you probably do, but do you have a routine that you actually practice, like what Christian was talking about?
All right, Rich, thank you for coming on our show. And if you are a small business owner or any type of business owner around here, and you want to be on Tip for Tip, all you have to do is go to bibbranding.co/tip for tip, and we'll get you on the show. Bye.